confused, overwhelmed, stressed. Delve into the truth as we take on this world with eyes wide open. Join Vicki, Elle, Niccie, and Teresa, four women, four decades, here to discuss issues that affect you. Expect a laughter, but we promise to be real and share God's truth as we let the video roll.
Oh, hi there.
Do it again.
Hi there.
Hi.
With eyes wide open, and we are coming to you today from a restaurant.
It's loud.
We're having dinner. It's loud. It's probably not the right lighting. Vicki's standing over my shoulder, but
it's all good.
But yeah, it's all good. And
what
we're
is the
here.
Name of this restaurant? Do you give them a shout out?
Giordani's from Chicago. But we're not in Chicago.
No, we're in Columbus, Ohio.
Yes, and so we wanted to talk to you, or talk tonight, today, about feeding our soul, spiritual food, because we're here tonight. We've been traveling all day. We have been working together, collaborating and doing things, and so we are so hungry. We cannot wait to get food. In fact, we devoured our salad, and now we're going to get into our pizza. But, we don't only have to feed our bodies, we have to feed our soul with the things that help us to live according to the truth. And so the scripture that we wanted to talk about is from Psalm 34:8, and it says, "Taste and see that the Lord is good." And so that's an experience. That is one of my favorite verses, because it talks about how Jesus is an experience. And so as we partake of him, as we partake of the word, and we take that in, we get to experience him in our souls. And so I love that.
Yeah.
You guys hungry?
Well, I am. And when you were saying that verse, I am reminded of the fact that it's like an action, something you must do.
That's good.
You can't just see him. It's not enough to just look and observe. You have to take him in.
Yeah.
And once you just take in Jesus and God and Spirit, I mean, it lives and breathes. It's alive in you. And, I mean, taste and see. We're talking about, feeding our soul, not just our bodies.
Yeah. Right.
And one of the things that we may not even know, and women are always wanting to lose weight. I think I don't know one woman that doesn't think she should lose at least 5 pounds. But sometimes we're on a spiritual diet and we don't even know it. We start to lose spiritual weight because we're not feeding ourselves with God's word, or we're not taking time to pray. I know I've done that to myself, and then when something comes along, I'm not nourished enough to be able to handle as well as I could have.
Right.
And usually it's my family that notices that I'm not nourished enough, because that's where I tend to react to, because they'll love me anyway, or at least I hope they do. But we need to be concerned about that nourishment that we need.
I love that you said that. I do health coaching also, and I love it, but I always talk about boosting your metabolism and how important it is, and to have a healthy weight is to really get that metabolism boost. I mean, metaphorically, I mean, how essential is that to do the things that we are going to boost our spiritual health? Get into the Word, pray diligently. Surround yourself and infuse yourself with like all kinds of ways that will feed your soul. Music and rest and quiet time. And I love that you said that.
I'm thinking that with something that you said, that we get strong, it's the authority that we can walk in. So when the storms of life come our way, we are standing in the strength. We're not a weakened soul, not able to stand up against the enemy that comes against us. But we can stand. One, we even recognize that it's him, and we recognize where it's coming from, the spiritual battle that's going on. It's not flesh and blood. And then we can stand in strength and might to be able to stand and be diligent, to stand and not be moved, because we're strong. We have an inner strength. I mean, that's just, I don't want to be weak. I don't want to be moved. I don't want to have the things of the enemy come and blow me over. I want to be unmoved. Strengthen myself.
We don't want to be weak.
Yes,
so, look at her. Teresa wants to say something.
Good move,
I can
Teresa.
Hear her kind of making noises. Okay, what do you got? Get in here.
No, there's no giveaways. Okay?
No.
Oh,
you caught me. No. Are you honestly going to give something? She's always trying to give away stuff.
Okay.
No, Vicki said something about the diet, and when we're hungry, we're cranky.
Yeah.
I think the same thing is said for when we're lacking in that spirit, that God's word.
Yes.
And I think you might have been saying it, Elle, but when we're filling our souls, there's so much more to this world. There's so much more to life, and there's so much more. I think we talked about friendship on another video, and I think friendships are even fuller when we are in God's word and we're sharing that. And just as you sit down and you share a meal with friends,
right? You're right in how, like you said, friendships, but it's your marriage, it's everything.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Literally feeding your soul helps you be more Christ-like, and every relationship you have is going to be stronger, better,
and not overwhelmed, because we've done a video on overwhelm. Uh-huh. We're even not as overwhelmed. And you know, you notice we're all here and we're sharing pizza, we're sharing salad.
Uh-huh.
So you can feed yourself with other people too. It's
right.
A beautiful thing to do. We can do it in the midst of fellowship. And you know, Bible studies are so amazing. Or just even study the word with a friend. Grab a friend. Sometimes we can feel very intimidated by going to a Bible study because we're not familiar with the word, or we're not, you know, familiar with how that all goes, or how I'm going to answer. So just grab a friend. And
yep.
You know,
they're feeling the same way.
Yeah.
Trust me.
Right. Everybody is. Everyone feels so intimidated. You know, they're just so, I don't know, nervous. Or
when you said, you know, we're sharing this meal together, I was thinking about one other thing is, what do you do before every meal? You pray. And I think, you know, if you're going to feed your soul, what a great concept to have is, you know, before you get to the word, you pray.
Yes.
Before you, you know, meet with your friend and you're going into, you open Bible study with prayer. I think that's so huge, inviting God in.
Yes.
Smith,
and I think, no, well, I was just thinking of Smith Wiggles.
I'm never sure. It's late.
It's Wigglesworth.
Here we go.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Oh, he's awesome. I love reading his books. But you know, when he sat down to eat, he would not eat of the physical, you know, the food for his body until he was in the Word. So he would read something from the Word of God. So he'd feed his soul, because that's more important to him than his body. So he fed his soul, and then he would feed his body. And I just always think about that. It just, he was always in the Word.
I have,
go ahead.
Oh,
no,
but
no,
Vicki,
no,
Vicki,
gotta go.
Ahead.
I will jump in here now. One of the things I just, when we're all different, and so some things will feed us more than others. For some of you, it will be music. For some of you, it will be prayer. For some of you, it might be listening to God's word on tape. For others, it will be reading God's word. And you know, we start out small. One of the things I have to be careful with is, like, if I'm going to read scripture, I tend to want to dig deep and find out what are the words mean and what was the setting.
Yeah.
And then sometimes what will happen is I'll think, oh, well, I'll do that later. I don't have quite so much time now.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to be careful with that, because maybe you have 5-10 minutes a day, but you have a half an hour. Start out with 5 or 10 minutes
it's
a day.
It's an appetizer.
That's right, an appetizer.
And
whets
the appetite.
Right, and find out what works for you, and then grow it. Grow it. These two think they're really cute. Well, all right.
But that's a good point. You just loved it.
Yeah,
you loved
it.
Or like, high five in it. There was something I was going to say.
Oh,
okay, one more thing. So when I'm health coaching, we talk about fasting a bit. And I was thinking, gosh, that's so strange. But the way that we do this is, like, I really like for people to do 3 to 4 hours between meals. This is a great time to fast. And it's a fasting that's healthy, but the mindset behind it is, every time you have a hunger and your mind goes to, oh, I have to feed that hunger, it goes to prayer. And so often what I'll do with these women that I coach, like in the morning, I say, okay, who's your firstborn? Every time you want to snack, binge, whatever, between that 3 to 4 hour window in the morning, every prayer, every thought, give it to God based on your son, your firstborn son. And then between the afternoon, make it your daughter, who's the next child. And then in the evening, make it your husband. And they're literally replacing their hunger cravings with prayer for a person.
Yeah, and fasting is really powerful, because we have to learn how to have self-control, because our soul wants and wants and wants and wants, wants the things of this world, the things that we crave, the things that are not of the Lord. And so when we fast from our bodies, from natural food, it helps us learn how to have control. So when those things, those cravings of our soul happen, then we know how to say no. We know that it just helps us to have control, self-control.
It develops it.
Yes, it does. It's a powerful force.
So Teresa's over here thumbing through the Bible.
Yeah. I think one of the things that we have to ask ourselves is, do we want to be a spiritual lightweight? Or do we want to be strong in the
heavyweight.
Spirit?
A heavyweight.
It's the only
heavyweight.
Time that you want to be a heavyweight.
My husband's a wrestling coach. Yes. That is so cool.
Yeah.
Heavyweight, lightweight.
Right.
Yeah. That's cool.
It is.
What you got there?
Well, I have our verse here. From the Psalm 34:8. Right? Yep. My eyes are getting bad on me now. Okay. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who takes refuge in him.
Yeah.
And you will never know if he's good unless you do what?
You taste it.
And so start a small amount of time and just learn to expand it. And the more you taste, the more you will know he's good.
It's like your palate matures.
Your appetite.
Yeah.
More and more and more.
So good. Okay. Yeah. Enough.
So good. Yeah.
What do we do? We can't really do it here.
Yeah. So Colossians 4:2. Pray diligently, stay alert,
with your eyes wide open
in gratitude.
Okay, and then, normally we're trapped here in their tears, but let's all step into truth and light.